Good morning, dear students. Previous class we discussed about the local anesthetics, different classes, the mechanism of action and the different techniques that are commonly used for this local anesthetic administrations. Today we discussed about some important individual local anesthetics drugs. We know this the most common uses of local anesthetics in exertions, dermatology, dentistry, spinal anesthesia. So what are the main importance of local anesthetics is comparing to general anesthesia. This local anesthetics is mainly acts on the peripherally nerves, and this the restricted area is affecting, and this the suitable in case of minor surgeries. Is a safe comparing to general anesthesia. The general anesthesia, this affects on the whole body, but this acts only on the restricted area. First we go to this history of local anesthetics. In Western Europe, there is a discovery started between 1715 to 1815. Chemists and physicians collected samples of coca leaves for experiments. This mainly isolated active principles of coca leaves. This synthesized to a drug for a patients to feel more relief of pain when taking surgeries. In 1816, German chemist Albert Niemann successfully isolated the active principles of coca leaf and he named it as cocaine. Yes, we go to the classes of local anesthetics. Bupivacaine, cocaine, benzocaine, tetracaine, chloroprocaine, procaine, atracaine, bupivacaine, gabapentin, etidocaine, lidocaine, and prilocaine. Today discussed about the important local anesthetics drug. This classification is mainly based on their duration of actions. Some of these shows the long action, short action, medium, ultra short acting. Mainly procaine and chloroprocaine shows the ultra short acting. Lidocaine and prilocaine are the short acting one. Mipivacaine and atracaine, these are the medium duration of action. And bupivacaine and etidocaine, these shows the long duration of action. This classification is actually based on the potency. Procaine and chloroprocaine, this shows the low potency. Tetracaine, bupivacaine and gabapentin, this drug shows the high potency. Lidocaine and mipivacaine, this shows the only intermediate potency. This is the pharmacokinetics of local anesthetics. Mostly these are administrated as oral, topical and injections. Previous class we discussed about the different categories of local anesthetics based on their chemical structure is amide linked and ester linked local anesthetics. Okay, all these pharmacokinetic actions are we already discussed. These are the commonly used local anesthetics in ophthalmic practice: lidocaine, bupivacaine, etidocaine, prilocaine, mipivacaine, hexilcaine, proparacaine and tetracaine. These are the most commonly used local anesthetics in ophthalmic practice. Some of these drugs are used in topical anesthetics as lidocaine or lignocaine 2 to 4%, tetracaine 0.5%, proparacaine 0.75%. Common regional anesthetics are lignocaine 1 to 2%, bupivacaine 0.5%, hexilcaine is 1 to 2%. Proparacaine is a topical anesthetics, its concentration 0.75%, which shows the one set of action 30 seconds. Cocaine is the first local anesthetics obtained from the leaves of plant Erythroxylon coccae. It is no more used in nowadays because of its corneal toxicity and addicting nature. Tetracaine is the amitocaine. This is a topical anesthetics in ophthalmic practice. One set of action in 30 minutes. Side effects are stinging sensation, punctures, drug allergy. Procaine is a first synthetic local anesthetics used as a small area infiltration and spinal anesthetics. It is poorly absorbed from the mucous membrane, so no topical use. A 2% injection is the usual preparation. Lignocaine is the most commonly used local anesthetics. In ophthalmology, 4% is topical and 2% infiltration solutions are commonly used. It has a quick onset of action and high degree of penetration. The drug is recommended for topical, nerve block, infiltration and epidural injection and for dental analgesia. It may cause drowsiness. Bupivacaine, this shows the onset of action is low. 0.75% solution produce anesthesia and for 8 to 12 hours is also used in ophthalmic practice, usually combination with lignocaine. Next is newer local anesthetics, levobipocaine. In recent years, this levobipocaine is a pure enantiomer, emerged as a safer alternative for regional anesthesia than its racemic parent. In common to all local anesthetics, levobipocaine reversibly blocks the transitions of action potential in sensory motor and sympathetic nervous fiber by inhibiting the passage of sodium through voltage-sensitive ion channels in neuronal membrane. These are the adverse effects are hypertension, nausea, post-operative pain, fever, vomiting, pruritus, back pain, headache, constipation, dizziness, fetal distress. Bupivacaine is another important newer one. Is a long-acting, enantiomerically pure, is amide local anesthetics, regional anesthetics with an efficacy is borderly similar to that of bupivacaine. It may be a preferred option because of its reduced central nervous system and cardiotoxic potential and its lower propensity for motor block. The drug is less cardiotoxic than equal concentration of racemic bupivacaine, but more so than lignocaine. It has a significantly higher threshold for CNS toxicity than racemic bupivacaine. Some of extensive clinical data have shown that epidural bupivacaine 0.2% is effective for the initiation and maintenance of labor analgesia and is provided pain relief after abdominal or orthopedic surgery, especially when given in conjunction with opioids. Bupivacaine had an adverse events profile similar to that of bupivacaine in clinical trials. Some of comparative data suggest that higher concentration of bupivacaine may be needed to provide the same sensory and motor blockage as bupivacaine 0.5%. These are some newer techniques of local anesthetic administrations. Previous class we discussed about most commonly used local anesthetics techniques like infiltration, epidural, surface anesthesia. This liposomal, these are the newer techniques of local anesthetics. These liposomes, this mainly acts as the carrier for this delivery of drugs. This liposomal bupivacaine formulation is the newer techniques for this local anesthetic administration. So we can conclude the advantages of local anesthetics. During local anesthesia, the patient remains conscious, maintains his own airways, excellent muscle relaxant effect, requires less skilled nursing care as compared to other anesthesias like general anesthesia. There is no inflammable. Thank you so much for your patient listening. This is my YouTube channel, Easy Learning. If you are interested, please go there. They have uploaded lots of videos with simple explanations. You can go there, like, share and subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you.